I want you to get up right now and go to the window, open it, and stick your head out and yell, "I'm as mad as hell, and I'm not gonna take this anymore!"
This guy gets it. I'm Cristen Conger, and you can consider this my letter of protest regarding these horrible working conditions. That's right, boss. I'm talking about sick building syndrome. And I can already hear you saying, "That's not a real thing, Cristen. Stop whining and get back to work explaining how yoga pants can cause acne." Well, no. The Environmental Protection Agency says sick building syndrome is real. And they define it as, and I quote, "a situation where a building's occupants experience discomforting health effects even though no specific cause can be found." And you know what else they say? That 30% of all office buildings in the United States could be sick. And it's not just offices either. SBS is a problem in schools, libraries, and even people's homes.
It's like everything everywhere is going crazy, so we don't go out anymore. We sit in the house, and slowly the world we're living in is getting smaller.
In the United States, the average person spends 80 to 90% of their time indoors. And you know what else? Offices with mechanical ventilation and without open windows are at more risk. So I hope you appreciate the health risk I am making by bringing this video to your eyes and ears right now. Well, what are those symptoms, you might have asked, if you cared about my well-being in addition to your own accumulation of knowledge? Headaches, dizziness, nausea, pain, fatigue, shortness of breath, coughing, and irritation of the throat, nose, skin, and eyes. And you know what that does? It reduces work efficiency and increases absenteeism. And let me stop you before you tell me that Tina in accounting doesn't have these symptoms, because inhabitants sharing the same office space are known to experience different signs of the illness. Many people, like Tina, are either misdiagnosed or don't even seek help. So you better believe public health officials when they say that seemingly minor complaints should be taken seriously.
All I know is that first, you've got to get mad. You've got to say, "I'm a human being."
Researchers still haven't identified a single cause for SBS. Most say it's likely a combination of things like chemical and biological contaminants, along with poor air ventilation. During an oil embargo in the 1970s, buildings in the US were made more airtight so the nation could conserve energy and building owners could cut costs. Sealing up buildings like this reduced ventilation down to 5 cubic feet per minute per person. But the American Society of Heating, Refrigeration, and Air Conditioning Engineers, and yes, that is a real thing, has revised their modern ventilation standards to a minimum of 15 cubic feet per minute per person. Exterior pollutants like exhaust and plumbing fumes, containing things like carbon monoxide, radon, formaldehyde, and asbestos, can all enter through poorly located intake vents. While inside, we're circulating volatile organic compounds from adhesives, carpeting, cleaning agents, synthetic fragrances, and even copy machines. What to do, what to do.
So, I want you to get up now. I want all of you to get up out of your chairs.
Some governments have established guidelines for acceptable levels of gaseous indoor air pollutants. And no, that wasn't a fart joke. So you could start by increasing ventilation rates, removing pollutant sources, and cleaning the air. The EPA also recommends routine maintenance of HVAC systems. Some houseplants might help too. A study out of the University of Cologne in Germany found that certain plants can absorb air pollutants. So, if you think your work environment is making you ill, talk to your colleagues and compare notes about your symptoms. I'm looking at you, Tina. I'm not gonna leave you alone. My life has value. You can start by leaving a comment below about your experiences with sick buildings. And for more angry rants about my work life, subscribe to this channel or visit us at HowStuffWorks.com.
I'm mad as hell and I'm not gonna take it anymore!
I'm mad as hell! I'm not gonna take it anymore!
I'm mad as hell!
I'm not gonna take it anymore!